In this example, we're looking at a protein that's being considered as a potential drug, and so some measurements were made of its denaturation at 25 degrees C. We found that the protein was 80% folded when urea, the denaturant, had a concentration of 1.5 molar, and it was only 35% folded when the urea concentration was 4 molar. So we want to use these data to make an estimate of what is the stability of the protein in the native conditions, namely when there's no urea present, by calculating delta G of unfolding in pure water. And we'll make some assumptions about the relation between delta G and the urea concentration. And these assumptions then involve a linear plot, and so we want to determine a term that's referred to as the M value of the protein, and this is absolute value of the slope of delta G unfolding versus this urea concentration. So we're going to use a notation which will indicate this denaturant, its concentration. So this is going to be the concentration of the urea, the denaturant. And we have condition, concentration is 1.5 molar, then it's 80% folded. And when the concentration is 4 molar, then it's only 35% folded. And so what we're going to do in this calculation is determine what's delta G of unfolding at these two conditions. And then we'll assume this linear dependence to estimate delta G when there's no urea present. And to calculate delta G, we're going to take advantage of, from thermodynamics, that delta G, in this case delta G of unfolding, is related to gas constant, absolute temperature, and the log of the equilibrium constant. Let's look at essentially the reaction that we're dealing with here. And so what we have the natural state, the folded. So this is the folded version of the protein. And it can go to the unfolded. And we're using this notation to indicate, in this case, relative concentrations. We don't know the actual concentration of protein. All we know is the fraction that's folded. And so, in equilibrium constants, since these are in equilibrium, an equilibrium constant would then be products over reactants. That's the equilibrium constant then in this delta G relation. So, delta G of unfolding is minus RT, the log concentration of unfolded, concentration of folded. And so, we have the fractions, so this means for our condition D1, so concentration D1, 1.5 molar, this ratio U over N, it's 80% folded, 20% unfolded, or 0.2. And for the higher urea concentration of 4 molar, then this ratio, 65%, is unfolded and 35% is folded. So we're going to substitute these numbers into our equilibrium expression. So I've started the substitution here. So this is K1 and this is K2. So our relation between Gibbs free energy change for unfolding, gas constant, absolute temperature, log of the equilibrium constant, put in the units, and this ratio 0.2 over 0.8. So delta G1 is 820 calories per mole if we do the calculation, or 0.82 kilocalories per mole. So we now can do the exact same calculation for delta G2. So I've substituted in the numbers the exact same way, and we get delta G2. Notice delta G1 is positive, but delta G2 is negative. And so now we're assuming there's a linear relationship. is delta G of unfolding and the concentration of urea. And so what I've done is make an Excel plot just to make it clear. Here's delta G of unfolding, kcals per mole. Here's the concentration of the urea, straight line. And essentially, we want to extend this straight line to the native condition. So the native condition where the concentration is zero. And so we can do a least squares fit to this line, just a linear regression. And if we do that, we get an equation that delta G of unfolding is related to the slope of the line. And so this is the slope times the concentration of the urea plus the intercept, 1.531. So this is the y-axis intercept. So the question, problem statement is asking, what's the value when the urea concentration is zero, the native condition? Well, that's just the intercept. It's delta G, then of unfolding is, and I'll just write two significant figures since that's all I think we can justify from the data. So this is the native, delta G, and we can see it's a positive value. We could go back and substitute in the same way we have just done, so we could calculate this ratio to determine stability, and I won't present the numbers here, but it's a straightforward substitution of the exact same calculation, and this ratio ends up being 0.079, which means this U is 0.073, and N then 0.927, or approximately 93% folded at the conditions of zero urea concentration. And then the last asks for the absolute value of the slope, which is referred to as the M value. So the M value, the absolute value, again, two significant figures, units, kilocalories per mole, and then molar. So this is the M value for this protein. And so we've now calculated the information about stability of the protein in the presence and the absence of denaturant, and then a value that's used in characterizing the stability as a function of the urea concentration.